y'all going through something. Huh? Some of y'all lose y'all praise when y'all got a little bit of money. Now you're looking down at everybody. But the same praise David had when he was tending to the sheep is the same praise that he had when he had to serve the enemy. When he had to serve Saul. Hallelujah. He still served Saul even when he was wrong. Now, can you serve somebody? Can you serve somebody even when they've done you wrong? Can you serve somebody even when you're suffering? Can you serve when you're broke and have no money in your... Can you serve when you're in the middle of a transition? Ask your neighbor, can you serve? He still served until his time came around. Amen. And I came to tell somebody, waiting is serving, and that serving is waiting. Waiting is serving, and serving is waiting. If you think about it, right? A waitress or a waiter has what? One assignment. They don't have two assignments, three assignments, four. They got one assignment, serve that table. They got one assignment to serve until they see the tick. And I just came all the way from Dover, Delaware to tell somebody, serve until you see the tick. It's gonna be more than you thought it was. It's not gonna be $5, but there's a miracle coming just because you decided to serve. Wow, yeah, man. Yeah. I said there's a tick coming down your road. Hey. And God is about to sign off on it. Hallelujah. While you're waiting, he said, I will renew the strength of my good and faithful servants. Israel hope, their hope was dried out. It was dried out. That's what the bones represented. It represented dead dreams. It represented bad decisions. It represented old faith. Somebody needs some new faith. Somebody need a refilling of the Holy Ghost. Because now the bones have dried up. There's no fire in it. Hallelujah. Jeremiah said it was like fire shut up in my bones. And now the bones have been dried out. Amen. And here's the problem. Because they couldn't distinguish what to serve and what didn't serve them well. Many of us are still serving things that never meant us no good. Maybe for a season it was all right to be in that ministry. Maybe it was all right for a season, hallelujah, to be with that person. Hallelujah, but why are you still with them? Why are you still serving something that's not serving you? Why are you still drained out? You trying to figure out why you tired? It's because you tied to the wrong things. You tired out when you come to church and can't give God a praise because you're drained out from serving something and not God. You drained out from serving something that God did not intend to be in your life anymore. But is there anybody who will choose to serve him when he only shows you a valley? Can I testify for a little bit? Can I testify how this